Way back when I was a young teenager in the early 1980s, Saturday morning TV viewing was extremely limited. We only had three channels to choose from back then, and between 9 a.m. and midday, the two main channels, BBC One and ITV, both showed fairly inane kids' programmes, which I found a bit dull. But the far less popular BBC Two often showed educational programmes from a British institution called the Open University, and one of the series that captured my young imagination was presented by a guy called Edward de Bono, who coined the phrase lateral thinking back in the late 60s. Lateral thinking is all about thinking outside the box to solve problems using an indirect and creative approach and reasoning that might not be immediately obvious to most people. It was an approach that really inspired me as a creative person, and as a result, I've generally arrived at good solutions to life's challenges only after having exhausted all the bad ones. But you know, c'est la vie. Anyway, the reason I'm telling you all this nonsense is because every now and then I see an idea during my research that reminds me of dear old Edward de Bono's process. And a perfect example is the concept of spherical solar panels. I mean, what's not to like about having a giant glorified glitter ball gently rotating on your roof, collecting sunlight from all angles? So could this represent a radical breakthrough in solar technology? Or is it just a very creative idea that might actually prove to be less practical in the real world? Hello, and welcome to Just Have a Think. One obvious limitation of a flat solar PV panel is that it can only use sunlight that falls directly onto its face. That means you either miss out on a bunch of otherwise available energy each day, or you spend money on solar trackers to keep the panels pointing in the right direction as the sun travels across the sky. The spherical solar cell design aims to boost solar power harvesting potential from nearly every angle without requiring any of those expensive moving parts. The lateral thinking for the design was actually inspired by nature, which, by the way, is often an extremely good source of ideas. In this case, it was the humble housefly that provided the blueprint for the concept, and specifically, the eyes. Evolution has selected a location and shape that increases the fly's angular field of view to about 270 degrees about itself. That's why you keep missing them with your rolled up newspaper. In the same way, the architecture of these spherical solar cells also increases the angular field of view, allowing it to capture sunlight from more directions. Rolling up silicon photovoltaic cells into a ball is not actually a new idea though. Japanese firm Sphelar have been developing these tiny PV microbeads since the start of the century for all sorts of applications, including wearable solar fabrics and semi-transparent glass building blocks. But the research team at the King Abdullah University of Science and Technology, or KAUST, in Saudi Arabia, are working with much larger spherical surfaces that they think could offer improved efficiency and coverage, especially when it comes to collecting reflected sunlight from backplate surfaces. Their current prototype is about the size of a ping pong ball, and initial lab tests have shown some very encouraging results. And before you go hurtling down to the comments section to point out that lab test results are not the same as real world results, I know, but you have to start somewhere, don't you? And the laboratory is usually that place, so bear with me here. Indoor experiments have apparently already shown that these things can achieve anything between 15 and 100% more power output than a flat solar cell with the same ground area, depending on the backplate materials used to reflect sunlight onto the rear faces. The team had already carried out previous research showing how to create thinner and more flexible solar cell designs based on a technique using corrugated grooves. To create this spherical solar cell, grooves were etched into a flat solar cell to make a pattern resembling a band of elliptical shapes connecting at the middle. That gave them the flex and bend that they needed to be able to fold the cell into its spherical shape. By simply shining a solar simulator lamp on both surfaces with no backing plates or anything like that, the team immediately saw a 24% increase in power from the spherical cell compared with the flat cell. And it got even more interesting as the panels heated up. Ironically, solar panels don't like getting hot. It reduces their efficiency quite significantly. But it started to become clear that the spherical cells seemed to be dissipating heat more effectively, and the result was at the elevated temperatures, the spherical cells produced 39% more power. The next experiment was to simulate scattered sunlight instead of direct sunlight. The differential between the two panels here was even greater, with about 60% more power coming from these spherical cells. But the most dramatic difference, and perhaps the biggest advantage of the spherical design, is its ability to receive reflected light onto its rear faces. Using backing plates made from either ordinary white paper or aluminium paper or even just plain sand, the power output of the spherical cells was shown to be as much as 100% greater than the flat cell. The key breakthrough in the team's research process was the development of that corrugation etching technique. A CO2 laser was used to burn through the protective polymer covering, allowing a reactive ion etching tool to create the grooves in the exposed area of silicon below. Those are all additional steps in the production process, of course, adding cost to the overall end product, and the loss of silicon surface area where it's been etched away will diminish the sunlight harvesting ability of the panel somewhat, but the team are convinced that those costs could be outweighed in certain specific real-world applications. For starters, you don't need the expensive automated solar trackers that I mentioned earlier, and in very hot regions like deserts, where more and more solar installations are being located these days, that heat dissipation advantage could be extremely significant. Plus, the spherical shape minimizes the accumulation of dust and sand, which is the blight of flat panels in hotter countries. So there'll be no need to pay people to wash the panels down each day or install some kind of mechanical system to do the job. The trickiest and most time-consuming step for the Saudi researchers was to manually fold the etched cells into the spherical shape. The cost of employing a workforce to perform that task would most likely be prohibitive, but the team say they're designing and developing ways to automate the process using robotic hands that can operate 24/7. The plan is to build and test large arrays of the spherical cells with the help of KAUST alumni teams all over the world, from California to New Zealand. The arrays will vary in size from 10 to 100 square meters, and the data gleaned from the trials will provide vital information on real-world functionality and cost benefits compared to existing operational flat panels. So will we be seeing utility-scale solar photovoltaic globes scattered across the land anytime soon? Well, maybe not. That market is already huge and growing exponentially, largely as a result of dirt-cheap flat panels being churned out in mind-boggling quantities over in China. But this kind of flexible tech may well find a place in more niche applications. The research team at KAUST are already working on new shapes that resemble tents or umbrellas, and they're also investigating the possibility of integrating their flexible solar cells onto the irregularly shaped surfaces of drones to provide a more effective and longer-lasting power source. And that sort of lateral thinking may also see these cells on a whole host of other products, including vehicle bodywork, uneven building surfaces, and mobile devices. As always, in the metaphorical Wild West that is the sustainable technology revolution, the proof will be in the pudding, so to speak. In other words, we'll need to see some sort of quantified cost summary of all those extra processing steps before any judgments can be made about the commercial potential of this idea. But if they can make the numbers stack up, then we might just have an innovation that would have made dear old Mr. De Bono very proud. No doubt you've got your own views on the viability of spherical solar, so why not jump down to the comment section below and leave your thoughts there. That's it for this week though. Just to let you know, I was invited to take part in a chat with the folks over at the Our Voices podcast recently, and you can listen to that at their website or wherever you normally get your podcasts from, and you can also watch it at their YouTube page. I'll leave links to all those in the description box below here. As always, a big thank you to the folks at Patreon who keep these videos completely independent and ad-free. And a quick shout out to the folks who've joined since last time with pledges of $10 or more a month. They are Robin Wales, Andreas Kohler, Dominic Sobresny, Michael Mitten, Ross Hammond, Dry Frog, Henning Karbstein, Dietmar Millinger, R.R. Schild, Richard Marcus, Eric Bruce Jochimson, Eric Bickford, Django Armstrong, Alice Sperova, Hugo Mathieu Visse, Lisa and David Mead, Gerald Fraser, Bob Cuckler, Caius Hawkins, Lu Ming Wang, Ed Randall, Joachim Ivaroff, Roland Plett, Donald Vig, Rod Nelson King, and Brian Bickerstaff. And of course, a huge thank you to everyone else who's joined since last time too. You can get involved with the team at Patreon and get the opportunity to exchange ideas and information with like-minded folks, plus watch exclusive monthly news updates from me, and have your say on future programmes in monthly content polls by visiting www.patreon.com/justhaveathink. And you can hugely support the channel absolutely for free by subscribing and hitting that like button and notification bell. It's dead easy to do all that. You just need to click down there or on that icon there. As always, thanks very much for watching. Have a great week, and remember to just have a think. See you next week.